Something, or else those rebels, they'll take the town.
I agree. What?
I would suggest that your lordship questions the prisoners.
Oh, no, please don't do that. I know nothing. I swear I don't know anything. Nothing at all.
Then, there's only one way to deal with this. That is, to attack the town.
Listen, my lord, the rebels are attacking the town. We just can't hold out any longer.
Many commercials.
People of Earth, hear this. I am the Martian King, Jim Crone, and I've come to conquer the Earth. But what I really want from you is the magic yin-yang pearl. You can save your lives by handing it over. Otherwise, after 3 days, we'll destroy the planet.
Yin Yang Po.
What shall I do?
Just get it off!
Yeah, all right, all right. All
come
right.
On.
Come into the house.
Father, what's wrong?
We'll talk inside. God, you had me worried.
Father, what's the matter then?
Something happened. Something strange. The Martians have come to Earth.
The Martians? How do you know, Father?
Because I saw them. They were on television.
Maybe it was just a cartoon.
You didn't see them?
Not me. I was playing a game of baseball.
Oh, you and your baseball. Your friend Fatty came here and told me that you'd suddenly disappeared. Huh? Yes?
Leo?
Yes, Leo speaking.
This is the police. Have you found your son yet?
Yes, he's back now. Thanks very much.
Good. Glad to hear it.
Thank you. Sorry to bother you. Thank you. Well, that was the police. They've had men out looking for you. Where on earth were you?
I lost my ball. It dropped in a hole near the temple. A big hole. It went real deep.
Huh? A hole?
Mm. And it went down into a cave. And there was a bright light there. And when I saw it, I just fainted. All right, Father. And I brought something back for you. I'll show you.
You didn't take this from the temple, did you?
I guess, but still, you collect them. And this one is different from your others. So then, I thought you should see it.
About 3,000 years old.
Oh, who is it? Has it got a name?
It's an old temple giant. It's said to have enormous strength, and legend has it could even push mountains into the sea.
Garbage.
Maybe it was some foreign television program.
Impossible.
Maybe a practical joke. Flying saucer stories, after all, have become a bit of a joke these days. Let's forget it. It isn't important.
What's the time?
11:45. It's late.
You're right. Okay, I'll take you home. In you go.
Right. Drive carefully.
I will.
Father! Father! What's wrong? Father! Father!
you know?
Oh, we're putting them into isolation. Right now, we're not sure. But you mustn't go near them.
Alan! Alan!
Hey, miss. Stop that.
Father.
Come back here.
Father!
Come here.
Father! Doctor, what is it? What's wrong? Is it food poisoning?
Don't know.
Doctor, what'll we do?
Don't worry. We shall soon find out what's wrong with them.
Doctor!
Afong. Present position, please. 200 and 4, 574. 245, 74. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Position 103 21 538.
The source is moving incredibly fast. Based on its present speed, I would say in 4 minutes it'll be over this city.
Captain, what are you planning to do next?
Nothing. We'll just watch its movements, see what it does. Possibly launch Universe 3.
That's good. That ship's our best weapon. It'll be a good...
The source's present position, 22 degrees north.
Going to surrender the magic yin-yang pearl.
Great, Chico. They're 100 years behind our technology. Why don't we simply blow the whole place to pieces?
You fool. You fool. You are stupid as these humans.
Yes, sir. You're right. That pearl has got to be around somewhere.
Chim Kung. If it's anywhere nearby, I'll go and get it.
You know, the reason I want that pearl is to make the sun mirror. And I'll use the sun's beams to make a death ray. Then not only can we control the Earth, but all the parts of the universe, all the stars!
Yes, sir. Great Chim Kung.
Now listen. We better search separately. The Pearl is somewhere around this city. Go!
Yes, sir. Great Jim Cook.
All right. Just you find that magic pearl, and I'll be the king of the whole universe.
Sir.
Going out.
What?
Hold it.
I must.
Don't be rash.
Captain, we can't let them destroy Earth. We must stop them.
But they're bigger than us. 50 times bigger. Our guns won't touch them. I'm afraid even our ships won't touch them. Don't go. You got no chance.
Without the magic pearl, they're not so strong. But once they get that, they can destroy the whole world.
Captain, I must go before they get it. Or who knows how many lives will be lost.
It's too dangerous. You're going blind. There's nothing known of them.
Captain, this way I can find out something about their weaponry. And if I die, so what? Save the world and the people. That's what counts. No, Captain. You're in charge of the center. You have a duty. Don't risk your life.
Tinda.
Captain, if I should get killed, continue the work with the jet ships, Universe 2 and Universe 3.
Tinda!
Tinda! Tinda! Come back!
Tinda!
Come back, you fool!
Come back!
Thank you.
stump me.
Chinua! You can't. You'd just be killed. There's no hope of winning. Chinua, you'd be going to certain death. So please, think a while. Our country needs you, needs your skill. Don't throw that away. Chinua, please listen. I mean, you must think of mankind as a whole, and not simply of avenging Tindar's death.
No good, no good! Even if we destroy the whole damn planet, that still isn't gonna get us the magic pearl.
Great Jim Kung, do you have a better plan then, sir?
My God, you're a fool! I must send your brain to the wisdom plant for readjustment.
Yes, sir. Great Jim Kung, enlighten me.
The magic pearl has a particular quality. When it's dark, it radiates an intense bright light. Understand what I'm getting at?
Yes, sir.
So when the sun goes down, the light is easily visible. And we should be able to find it.
How are they?
Doctor, have you diagnosed it?
They're suffering from radiation poisoning.
What? It can't be. There's nothing radioactive in the house.
Hey, it could be. Your father collects antiques. Possibly he picked up something dangerous, radioactive.
Right, right.
Doctor, look after them.
Of course.
Thank you, Doctor.
Let's go back.
Right.
We're getting something. Seems I was right.
It's strange. What could it be?
Listen. When you came in and found them, where were they lying? Can you remember?
Right there.
You're right. This is it.
That thing?
One, two, three.
It isn't dangerous. High intensity.
High intensity X-ray on.
My God, it's got arteries.
It's obvious. It's not of Chinese origin. But still, it's very old.
But why does it have high radiation?
Been near a high radioactive source for a very long time.
That makes sense. Still, what could it be?
Apart from the sun, what else is there?
There's the magic pearl.
Hey, right. Perhaps it was near the pearl.
And those Martians, they want that pearl.
Right. The pearl gets the sun's rays during the day and so becomes radioactive. At night, it gets the moon's rays and loses its potency then.
Listen, we've got to find that pearl before the Martians or they'll destroy us.
You're dead right. The pearl could be their most powerful...
Let's find it. But where?
Right. The statue. Ask your dad where he found it. Said it was round about here. Ah, here's the hole, look.
We've discussed the various sightings, but we don't know how the Martians materialize. They simply appear. One thing's for sure. Our conventional weapons are completely useless against the Martians. Even our nuclear weapons. I'm sure of it. Now, this time, let's record our sympathy at the death of Dr. Tindar. It was a great loss to all of us. Concerning this magic pearl, the Martians have it now. Let's hope they don't use it.
In my opinion, the reason why they had to get the pearl...
Watch this! I will let you taste the superior science of Mars! Devastating power of my deadly sun mirror. All right, it's ready.
You produce the invincible sun ray mirror.
Those x-rays have made it grow. It's so much bigger.
At least five times its size.
Funny. I swear I felt some sort of force inside. Suppose...
Listen. You must activate this force.
Right. That's what I'll do.
Father said he was the ancient warrior god. Had enormous strength. Now, if we could revive him, then maybe he could beat those Martians.
Hmm. We can try. First of all, let's see. What we'll need is some sort of control. So that we can direct him at a distance.
Right. Well, let's get started then.
Mm. Captain! Captain! Oh, Captain. A cable from the American Space Agency. They sent their giant robot up to the moon.
Yeah!
Chin Kung. It's bad news.
All right. What happened to put you in such a panic?
Great Chin Kung. Something terrible. Look there. You see that? Those two flying objects? They've been launched from Earth. And they're coming in to attack us. Great Chin Kung. What do we do? What do we do?
Don't worry. Just keep calm. They're coming to certain death here.
You attack me, you monster. So, you're one of the Martians. I can handle you space creatures. You're no problem at all. I'll bust you up and turn you into scrap. Will ya? Don't try your tricks. I got a few, you don't know, I promise you. We'll see. Damn you. I'll finish you. Okay, try this. Turn you a piece of tin. Take that. They've fallen for my trap. Just. They're fighting each other. Poor mankind. All right. Activate the sun ray now. And destroy the earth. Ready?
Captain, cable from the American Space Agency. They request us to stop the fight between their giant and our temple giant.
Damn. Front body interference. Can't get a signal through. Listen, I'm going up.
Well, all right, I'll go with you.
Likely.
You can't trick me like that. I'm not that stupid.
Calling Temple Giant. You're fighting with the American astronaut robot giant. You're supposed to be allies. Stop fighting. Calling Temple Giant. You're fighting with the American astronaut robot giant. You are supposed to be allies. Stop fighting. Calling Temple Giant. You're fighting with the American astronaut robot giant. You're supposed to be allies. Stop fighting.
What's wrong? God, oxygen's gone. Listen, don't worry. I'll turn back. We'll soon be back on Earth.
Those idiots. They fell straight into Jim Kong's trap. I've never seen such a pair of dumb fools.
Stay right there. Go. I got you now.
Aren't you dead, ugly face?
I'll give you ugly face.
Whoa!
I see. American style wrestling.
All right, you horrible thing. Try taking me on, eh? You have dishonored me. You must die.
Oh, great Chen Fong, forgive me. Please, my lord. Please, my lord, forgive me.
American Giant, thank you for your help. And now the two of us must cooperate to destroy the sun mirror and recover the magic pearl as well. Ready?
Right. Let's find those Martians. They've disappeared!
Thank you.
You stupid, useless American robot, you! I can easily destroy you no matter what you do. Nothing you do
me!
Strange. Where's the American robot gone? Maybe it's a trap set by the Martians.
Ship 3, ready for action.
Ship
going to his death. Robot, wake up, wake up! All right, try some of my gas! How do you like that? No effects, I'll get you. Yes!
Robot, wake up! Wake up!
Thank you. Still much to do to complete our mission here.
Right. We must cooperate to destroy the Martians now.
Right. So in future, the world can enjoy peace.
Right. Let's go. Ready? I don't believe it. That humans are so stubborn. My God, it can't be so difficult to conquer the Earth. I won't give up. I won't.
Great Jim Cone, please don't be angry. I'll conquer mankind for you. And I'll destroy the Earth as well.
You? Who do you think you are? It's me who is the king of the universe. I'll destroy them. We'll use the death ray, and that will finish them. Hurry! Aim the ray now. On maximum power!
Yes, sir. Great Jim Cone.
Hurry! They're coming! Very good. Very good!
So take this back now to where it really belongs. From now on, mankind will enjoy permanent peace.
And all thanks to you.
No. The real credit goes to mankind. I have to go. Goodbye.
Right. God be with you.